these applications for the establishments of institutions, not only in the public sector, but also in the private sector. So essentially, the press briefing of today is to provide information on our activities, the programs we do, available learning opportunities for prospective students, for all other stakeholders and the general public. I'll make a brief presentation. In most of the buildings in this place to serve as a reminder and also as a commitment that we are working continually to enhance the quality of our academic programs. The vision to be a reputable institution producing high quality graduates for outstanding impact on global socio-economic development, as well as academic knowledge for active participation in global socio-economic development. And then our philosophy, total education of the individual, is a prerequisite for sustainable socio-economic development. To guide us in achieving these mandates, the vision, mission, and philosophy of the institution, we have strategic plans, strategic objectives, and operating now presently is a 5-year strategic objective of the institution in terms of programs that will come on stream, in terms of infrastructural development that will guide us. And a lot more is encompassed in the university academic brief that shows a lot of the activities that will go on over the next 20 years. Next slide. You might join us before the end of this press briefing. To actualize his dream of contributing to educational service delivery in this state and Nigeria as a whole, the university was given license in 2016 by the federal government of Nigeria, and the doors were open academic activities in March 20, students, 49 to be precise, students. And that's why, even though the university is barely 2 years old, March this year will be exactly 2 years, we are at 300 level. Because as the license was issued 2016-2017, 2017-2018, this is the third 300 level. Now, the Faculty of Basic and Applied Sciences, what we have is one of 10 in some institutions, world-class institutions overseas. You don't need to have too much fragmentation. You have a number of faculties lumped together. So our Basic and Applied Sciences has a number of programs, basically programs. So we offer degree programs in biology, health sciences, mathematics, computer science, and physics. And if you go back to the previous slide, then we have our laboratories. Each of the science programs has a commensurate lab. Then we also have the next slide. Next. The Faculty of Humanities, Management, and Social Sciences. That would be the like, three faculties lumped into one. Now, for the available programs, English Language, Linguistics, Accounting, Banking and Finance, Business Administration, we have a degree program in Entrepreneurial Studies, in Marketing, in Management, Hospitality Management, Tourism, Economics, Political Science, Public Administration, Sociology, Peace and Conflict Resolution, Criminology and Security Studies. Some of these programs are new. Academic year 2018-2019, we kickstarted the Faculty of Law. That's the building there. There are also other buildings for the faculty coming. That we've admitted, kick-started this academic year, is the Faculty of Basic Medical Sciences. As you came into the campus, the structures to the left, that's the Faculty of Basic Medical Sciences. And opposite it is the University Hospital. So that area will be like the hub of the medical school, which will start in October this year. That's medicine and surgery. Now, for basic medical, we have the following programs: anatomy, physiology, public health, nursing science, medical laboratory science, radiography, physiotherapy, and optometry. Optometry, this may be the second or third university where that program is offered in Nigeria. Next slide. Before we get to the major challenges, as an institution, after being given my place, there is the governing council, there is the senate, this is our senate chambers, we have the management board, and of course, deans of faculties, heads of department, coordinators of programs. The governing council has been appointed, and the governing council started sitting in 2017. And their mandate, they're supposed to meet here, and they've been doing that. Now, other than the governance structure, in terms of human resources, the academic side, the non-academic side, the staff strength presently stands at about 144, about 74 of them are non-academic staff, about 40-something are academic staff, and then we have other supporting staff, the university security, people in the canteen, the porters, in the hostels, etc. Now, for the academic staff, as obtained globally, we have full complement of full-time staff, we also have part-time staff, and adjunct lecturers, all drawn from institutions around us. That's for the part-time and adjunct lecturers. On student admissions, presently is ongoing during my introductory part of this press briefing. We said it will give us an insight into available learning opportunities. And these are the programs. Now, admission is ongoing, and so far for this academic year, we've admitted close to 300. And if we add that to the existing student population, we started with 50, and the second year we admitted almost 300. And the second year. So by the time we conclude admissions, end of this month, based on the job policy guideline, private universities can admit until January 31. We hope that the student population by then will be about 800. Presently is about 700. We expect before this month runs out, we should admit at least 100 more students. Now we have support services other than the academics for the students. The medical center is there. And we have sports arena, basketball, table tennis. And the sports arena, sporting facilities, indoor, outdoor sporting facilities, all available. In terms of teaching delivery, we have enough lecture rooms, more than enough for the population we have now. More than enough, we have enough lecture rooms. Laboratories, reasonably equipped, I would say that they have met global standards of world-class universities, but we will reach there. So we have laboratories, teaching delivery, the what's called online educational resource, which the National Universities Commission is promoting, that as far as possible, lectures should be made available online so that the students can access them. So we've achieved at least about 40% of that. Most of our lectures are available online under the Open Educational Resource that we have. Now, in terms of challenges, it's not all rosy. As the student numbers increase, definitely the need for more infrastructure comes up. So challenges in terms of funding to meet the growth of the institution. Being a private university under Nigerian law so far, Europe will change soon. As a private university, we cannot benefit from such facilities as the Education Tax Fund, the Tertiary Education Trust Fund, TED Fund. We don't have access to those funds, which the public universities are using, mostly in terms of infrastructural development and supporting research and conference attendance. So we don't have access to that. Most of what we have has to come from the revenue we generate professionally, stakeholders that do come in to assist. Outside infrastructural development, I'm sure as you came in here, you saw the state of the access road to this place. The access road and of course the internal roads not too good, although we try to maintain them, but definitely they'll be better off when tarred. So we do hope so the required support, especially with the access group, which we understand, maybe as we drive up, we will see some signs that the state government has worked on that road. So at least on paper, I believe they have worked on it. So we do have challenges, and the area of infrastructure, maybe we would need more hostel accommodation. The accommodation we have now, if we stretch it, take the 800 students we have. But beyond that, we definitely need a lot more hostel accommodation. We're also working towards, in terms of community development, which is one of our mandates as a university. Community development, we have a hospital that is open to the community, not that it is free, but it's subsidized in a way, making it open. And we've come up with some arrangement with the National Health Insurance Scheme, NHIS. So, the basis of that, the may get some referrals from the public institution in the city corner, Babu area, all those health centers. We may get referrals from there to this place. Also, in the context of community development, we have a few students, I think about three or four from the community that are actually studying on scholarship in this university. And in the area of research, we haven't made much inroads there, being a new university. But as we equip, the research facilities will also improve. But meanwhile, we have reached out to, in the area of what you may call traditional medical practice, for which this area is known, Akpabio area. We are developing a platform in which some of the traditional medical practitioners will be able to come in here and hopefully interact with scientists that will possibly help us get into some of maybe developing patents for some of the things they use. By and large, most of that knowledge is traditional knowledge, is locked up in families. And as those harboring them die, a lot of those things disappear. We do hope we have reached out to them already that they will be able to share.